Today we'll do anti-adrenergic drugs, sympatholytics and adrenergic receptor antagonists. So these are the drugs which antagonize the receptor action of the adrenaline and the related drugs. Alpha adrenergic blocking drugs. For the introduction, these are the drugs which will inhibit the adrenergic response mediated through the alpha adrenergic receptors without affecting those which are mediated by beta adrenergic receptors. They bind either reversibly or irreversibly to the alpha receptors. Then they prevent the activation of exogenous catechol amines. Classification is very important. Alpha 1 selective, alpha 2 selective and non-selective. Alpha 1 selective, we have prazosin, terazosin and doxazosin. Here we have yobimin, and then we have phentolamine and phenoxybenzamine. I'm not wrong. Yes, phenoxybenzamine. So the general effects of the alpha blockers. So we'll remember it through this CHMNDT tone in case we forget it. So the generalized effects. So we'll understand them by going from one system to the another. So vasoarterial dilatation. This is that they cause blockade of the vasoconstrictors at the alpha 1 receptors, due to which there is a reduction in the peripheral resistance, there is a reduction in the cardiac output, heart rate, venous return, and then there is a fall in blood pressure. So then we also have a point here that is related to postural reflex. It is indicated in this if a patient is receiving alpha blockers, example prazosin and other alpha adrenergic blockers from hypertension. So the person should not stand up suddenly after being into a supine position on the dental chair, because then he'll suffer from postural hypotension. So these are the patients which are more prone to develop hypotension. Okay, the alpha blockers abolish the pressor action of adrenaline, due to which there is a decrease in the blood pressure due to beta 2 mediated vasodilation, and this phenomenon is called as vasomotor reversal of tail. Then we have reflex tachycardia, because there is a fall in the mean blood pressure due to increased release of noradrenaline. Then there is a blockade in the presynaptic alpha 2 receptors. Then we also have an important hair function, nasal stuffiness and meiosis. That is the blockade of the alpha receptors in the nasal blood vessels as well as in the radial muscles of iris. Hypotension. So the alpha 2 receptor blockage is done by them. Then there will be a decrease in the renal blood flow, jiske karan there will be a decrease in the glomerular filtration rate. Then there will be more reabsorption of sodium and water in the tubules, due to which there will be more retention and expansion of the blood vessels, causing hypertension. Further, this is also increased by the release of renin. Reflex increase in renin. Okay. Then the tone of smooth muscles in bladder, trigon, sphincter and prostate is reduced due to the blockage in the alpha 1 receptors, mostly alpha 1a subtype. Urine flow in the patients who suffer from benign hyperatrophy of prostate is improved. Then we have contraction of vas deferens. It also inhibits the ejaculation. Then side effects may palpitation, postural hypotension, nasal blockage, fluid retention, inhibition, inhibition of ejaculation and impotence, dizziness and intraoperative floppy iris syndrome. Now we will go to one each drug. Phenoxybenzamine. So phenoxybenzamine, as I told earlier, has a mixed, that is a non-selective competitive mechanism. That is, it is going to stimulate both alpha 1 and alpha 2 type of receptors. Correct. It is a non-specific alpha blocker, covalent bonding, irreversible. Then it cyclizes spontaneously in the body, and it gives rise to a very reactive ethylenamine intermediate, which is responsible for alpha adrenoreceptors and other biomolecules by forming strong covalent bond. Then it blocks the action of acetylcholine, histamine and 5-hydroxytryptamine. It is limited in use because alpha 2 blocking effect leads to release of norepinephrine from presynaptic terminals, causing heart rate and cardiac output to increase. This is mainly used in pheochromocytoma. This is a tumor of the adrenal medullary cells, occasionally in secondary shock. Then we have peripheral vascular diseases, Raynaud's disease, then frostbite. Okay. Then coming on to the another non-specific alpha blocker, which is phentolamine. This is also a non-specific, rapidly acting and a reversible blocker. Whereas earlier we saw that